Oi, how you doing? It's me, your boy Waddles. Welcome back to the Minecraft Guide, episode number 12. I'm hyped for what we're going to work on in today's episode. What we're doing today is going to set us up big time for even more enchanting. Didn't mean to switch the view there. That's my bad. Now, last episode went really, really well. If you caught it, then you already know. Then we have a full set of diamond armor, not to flex or anything, but yeah, it looks good over here. Now, for now, I'm going to leave the diamond armor inside of the enchanting room on this armor stand. Why? Well, I think I'd like to save this diamond armor for netherite armor. That's right, we're gonna jump right from iron now to netherite. So that stuff's just gonna sit there for now until we get netherite, which honestly, probably won't be too far off from now. We're also probably going to wait to enchant the rest of that set until it's netherite. Netherite has a higher enchantment value, which basically means we'll have a better chance to get better enchantments from the enchantment table if it's netherite. Also, if you saw the last episode, you know things went amazingly well, and not only in the diamond department. Last episode, we found 3 spawners. The important one, the one that we care about today, is the zombie spawner, the first spawner that we found. Today, we're going to turn that zombie spawner into our experience farm for this little, I guess, starter base area, if you will. It'll also probably be one of the only zombie farms in the world, maybe ever, even. This farm will give us a continuous supply of experience, rotten flesh, and likes. That's right, hit that like button right now. Got you again. So zombie farm. Let's kick things off by jumping into the materials. What do you need to get to build a zombie spawner XP / rotten flesh farm? Well, you're gonna need signs. I recommend starting with at least 24. We're probably going to end up using more though. You're also going to need a single block of soul sand. Just one. So go to the nether, grab one, and then dip out of there. As with any build, I always highly recommend that you have building blocks ready. Now, this farm is going to require digging, so you're going to want to have a decent pickaxe, probably. Like we're talking, at least iron. We're also going to bring a lot of wood with us over to our build site and a stone cutter so we can make block variants. Also, to make this farm, you will need at least 1 water bucket, but 2 is better. 2 is twice as good as 1, which is definitely good. And then there are 2 more materials that I actually don't have quite yet that you're gonna need to get to take on this project. Material number 1, kelp. Kelp is pretty easy to find. Go to an ocean, dig this stuff out. I recommend getting at least 1/2 a stack of kelp. Now technically, the kelp is optional. We'll be using the kelp in this farm to turn flowing water blocks into water source blocks. You could do this manually by hand with water buckets, but it's a pain. It takes a long time, so I highly, highly recommend that you just go and find some kelp and bring it with you. It'll speed things up a lot. Alright, so 51 kelp, that should probably definitely cut it. Now the final material that we need to grab is going to be a little bit more tricky. To build this farm, to have this farm actually work correctly, we're going to need at least 1 block of ice. Ice is something that we actually don't have quite yet. Now getting ice might be a little bit tricky. You will need Silk Touch to get a block of ice in your world. Now, if you know where a frozen ocean is, go over to the frozen ocean, take some ice off of one of the icebergs. If you don't know where a frozen ocean is, like us, you're going to need to go really high up in your world, where there's snow. If you have a snowy in your biome, that's perfect. Go there. You can go anywhere inside of a snowy biome and set up what we're about to set up. If you don't have a snowy biome near you though, then you're gonna need to go really, really high up in your world, like above Y95. Now conveniently, I have snow right here on top of this mountain. This will definitely work. We are also way above Y95 up here. We're actually at Y102, very, very high. So first things first, get really high in your world or find a snowy biome, like a snowy tundra. After that, we're gonna wanna dig a 3x3 area out, just like that. Place no light sources around this area. Also, make sure there are no blocks above this area. After that, place water sources in this 3x3 thing, and then we wait. Eventually, this water, because we're up high in a cold, cold biome, will actually convert over to ice, but the water needs to be a solid block of water, so not flowing. Something just like this will 100% work. It's just a matter of time. Now I'm going with a 3x3 here. Technically, you don't have to go with a 3x3. You can put 1 water source down and then just wait. But if we go with a 3x3 and we let all of this turn into ice, it's gonna take a little while, but if we let that happen, then we can go ahead and take that and craft it into 1 single block of packed ice. Ice that will never melt. But boom, look at that, right there, we have an ice block that is formed in here, which is perfect. Once you have an ice block that's formed, grab Silk Touch, right here we have an iron Silk Touch pickaxe, and mine it. Then, right there, we have a block of ice. Nice and simple. So that's how it's done, a basic ice generator. I'm thinking that later on in this world, we'll probably build a bigger, better, more cool one, but for now, this is the basics. All we need to get is one block of ice. Technically, I already have it, but I'm going for one block of packed ice. So that means I'm gonna need to wait it out up on top of this mountain for a little while and grind out just a tiny bit more ice. Once I have that, I'll meet back up with you guys over at the spawner with all of our supplies. Alright, the ice has been copped. Now our beautiful, beautiful spawner is located right inside of this hole. It's actually not that far below the surface. Now really quick, what do we have? We have a 67. Hey, ooh, that's not a good number for a surface spawner farm. Oh no, I was really hoping. Let's see, what do we have down here? 49. Yikes, that's like a little bit past 16, so we would have to take the surface down a little bit. No, never mind. We're not going to do that. Initially, I was thinking that we'd put the grinding room, basically the room where we take the zombies out from, up on the surface, but that's a little bit far. Instead, maybe what we could do is my backup plan, which is in this room right here. We could basically make a room down here where we're going to drop the zombies into and take them out in this room. You see, for the spawner to be active, we need to be within 16 blocks of it. Right now, we're within 1, 2, 3, and so on. As soon as we move more than 16 blocks away, the lights on the spawner, those little flame particle effects, are going to turn off and the zombie will stop spinning. If all of that happens, then this spawner won't actually spawn any more zombies. Now, there is a workaround to it. We could raise the zombies up, drop them on the surface, which would be fine, and then just have a different AFK spot, but I don't really like the idea of that. I'd like to be able to be taking out the zombies and spawning more zombies at the same time. Long story short, for your spawner to be active, for it to actually spawn mobs, you need to be within 16 blocks of it. But that's not the only requirement for a spawner to spawn mobs. If you want your spawner to spawn more mobs, then the original mobs need to be moved out of its detection box. The spawner's detection box is a 9x3x9 area, so basically, 4 blocks out that way, 4 blocks out that way, 1 above, 1 below. So, basically, the goal here is to let the zombies spawn, move them out of that area as quick as possible so more zombies can spawn ASAP. Admittedly, all of that might seem pretty complicated if you're new to this stuff, but really, trust me, it's not that bad. So, what we're doing today will work for zombies and skeletons. We're stuck with a zombie spawner though, a little bit of a bummer, but it's gonna be cool. So first things first, we're gonna wanna drop a slab on top of the spawner. Of course, when we're talking about moving mobs away from the thing, if there were to be a mob idling on top of the spawner, it wouldn't be moving away. That would be a huge, huge problem. Slab on top of the spawner, no matter what. Now this chest over here is basically the chest from this room. I actually combined the two chests when I was dropping stuff off in the last episode. Basically, it needs to go. We're done with it over there. For now, we're gonna set up a little bit of a work area right over here. We'll put our chest down, we'll put a bed right there, we'll put a stone cutter right there, and then finally, crafting table right there for now. We'll also go ahead and make an infinite water source really quick, so we have more water when we need more water. So boom, water source there, space in the middle becomes an infinite water. Pretty simple. So far, so good. Now let's talk spawner room prep. First things first, you need to get rid of the chests inside of this room, and you need to put torches in this room. We don't want spawns to happen while we're working on this. If spawns happen, we're gonna have a problem. I'm also going to want to light up the cave around this area, which conveniently, I've already done. If a creeper were to walk into this room and go boom while I was working on it, then the spawner would go away and I would go cry and it would be bad. So yeah, make sure your cave is either blocked up or lit up very, very well. We have a lit up cave, so that's going to be perfect. We're also going to actually end up blocking this cave off, so technically, I guess it doesn't matter. Now, it's time to work on the room. First, let's talk height dimensions. Right now, the ceiling is 1, 2, 3 blocks up from the spawner. That is a beautiful, beautiful height amount. The ceiling needs to be either 3 blocks or 2 blocks above your spawner. If you have one of those, you're good to go, which you definitely should. So in terms of the height dimension, we're good. We already have that slab on top of the spawner, so that means we can talk about the horizontal room. You want your walls inside of your spawner room to be 4 blocks away from your spawner in every single direction. Now, if you put your torches on your wall, like I did when digging this room out, make sure you put new torches back, otherwise more mobs are gonna spawn, gonna be a headache. So our wall over here is gonna be sitting right there, and then over here, finally, we need to remove 1 block. So we have 4 blocks out right there, 4, 4, 4. Now we need to take all of these other blocks out. What we're going for is a 9x9 room. 9 in one direction, 9 in the other direction. Don't worry about digging the floor out quite yet, we'll talk about that in just a second. First, to get rid of the walls. Now, if you have a room like me that kind of cuts through a cave, which you probably do, you can go ahead and block off that wall. See, we want to control the mobs that spawn from this thing as much as possible, which means we obviously definitely need to eliminate their exit points. So no exit over there, we don't need that spot there. And then over here, what we're going to do is actually leave a little bit of an entrance so we can get up and down and actually work on this thing. Actually, I'll leave that down for now. But other than that, we're going to go ahead and fill everything in, just so it's nice and ready. Now I got dark over here. Oi, yep. Exactly why you keep it lit. Go away, green guy. Go away. Nobody likes you. Alright, so let's go ahead and convert this ice into packed ice. Boom. Very fancy. And blue ice recipe. Very expensive. And then, let's actually go ahead and craft a few ladders. But, just a few. These ladders are going to be my ticket up and down into this room. So maybe 9. 9 should probably be more than enough. Here's what we'll do. And to be clear, this is totally optional, but ladder right there. And then, after that, after I take the rest of these walls out, we'll probably end up putting more ladders. But anyways, time for me to dig. More dig, less talk. Alright, little bit of digging later, no talking, and boom. We have a 9x9 room with the spawner dead center. Now let's talk about the floor. When it comes to the floor, you have some options. Your floor at minimum should be 3 blocks down below the spawner. That's the minimum though. If you want, you could go something like, 5 blocks below. don't dig straight down. That's my bad. Yeah, we're gonna go 5 blocks down below the spawner. This 5 block deep floor will give us a lot of clearance when it comes to this spawner. Zombies will spawn and then drop down here, which is absolutely perfect. Also, because my floor is so far down, I can make my spawner look pretty and put a slab on the bottom. Boom. Symmetry. Amazing. Now it's my job to be real with you, elites. Being 100% real with you, I don't care about how ugly this room is today. I just don't. I couldn't be bothered to care about it because I'm never going to see into it. Even with my grinding room being located down in the cave system, like I wasn't initially planning, I just still don't plan on actually making a window into this room. If you've seen the other guy seasons, you know that sometimes I do that. I like a glass room looking into here, maybe a fence wall, something cool like that, but no, not this time. This time, we're going for just getting the room done. Seeing as I won't ever see into this room, actually, I don't care about how it looks. It could look absolutely garbage like it does right now, and that's fine, that's cool with me. But if you do care about how your room looks, now is the time to actually care about it and take care of it. Working on the aesthetics later, once this farm is up and running, would be a nightmare. That would be a huge headache. So if you want your walls to look pretty, do them now. Swap them out for stone bricks or maybe granite, because granite's a beautiful block, or andesite even. Whatever you want to do, whatever you like. But if you're going to do that in this step. Same goes for the ceiling and the floor. Which brings me to an interesting point. So I don't care about how this room looks, right? Mm-hmm, right. That's definitely what we just established. But I'm gonna go ahead and make the floor look cool because there's already a hole in it. I'm already gonna have to replace it, so I might as well go that extra mile and make the floor look cool. So instead of just a boring cobblestone floor, we're gonna do cobblestone and mossy cobblestone. But of course, I'm cheap. To conserve blocks, we're just gonna go ahead and use slab variants. Slab variants are going to be a little bit cheaper. It'll save me on some blocks, which is a concept that I definitely like. But anyways, I have some blocks to dig out and a floor to lay in now. And a ladder to continue downwards. Okay, scratch that. The ladder's good. But the floor, the blocks, they're not good yet. Alright, so boom, here we have a nice and bright room that is 9x9x9 now. Now again, to be clear, you don't have to make your floor 5 blocks deep. Oh my gosh, what is this? This is horrendous. Okay, actually, here's the masterpiece in all of its glory. Beautiful, I know, right? I know. So, we have the room dug out. Again, to be clear, your floor does not have to be 5 blocks down. We're just going with 5 because that's my magic number today. So, the point of this farm is experience. Rotten flesh, but also experience. The zombies are going to be giving us experience. At this point in the build, we have to kind of make a little bit of a choice. If we wanted to, we could finish this build up really quick by making one water stream somewhere in this room to move zombies to one singular block, and then we could stand on the other side of that block, you know, like trap the zombies in an area, swing at them with my sword over and over again, and then the zombies would be taken out. It would work, but it would be really tedious, and my sword would probably take a lot of durability damage. Basically, not good. So option number one, have to hit the zombies like a million times. Option number two, have to hit the zombies one time and one time only for them to go away. That's going to save our sword a lot of durability and make this farm a whole lot more easier and enjoyable to use. We're definitely going with option number two. So to get the zombies that are going to spawn from this spawner down to a one-hit kill, we're going to need to take a lot of health away from them. How do we do that easily? Well, simple. Fall damage. We can raise the zombies up really high, let them drop, they'll take a bunch of damage, then we hit them once and boom, they're gone. Their existence, it's over. If we drop the zombies 22 blocks, or 23, they'll be brought down to a one-hit kill. If we drop them 24 blocks, they will die on impact. We don't want that. Now, I recommend going 22 blocks just to be safe. You never know, maybe the zombie takes a little bit of damage somewhere along the line somehow. To sort of account for that, 22 blocks, but if you're living on the edge, go 23, but 22 is our golden number. So, with that in mind, we need to pick a side to move the zombies to. Our room for grinding the zombies is going to be over in this general area, which means we want to move the zombies over there. If we want to move the zombies that way, we have to pick either this wall or this wall to transport them. I'm thinking, maybe, that we'll use, let's see, our base is over that way, so let's actually use this wall. What we're gonna do is dig out the floor along this wall, one block wide, one block deep. This is going to be an additional water trench. You see, eventually we'll put a bunch of water sources back there, they'll all flow over here, then we'll have a water source right here, flowing this way into a mob elevator. But little problem, this is 9 blocks, water only flows 8 blocks. So what do we do to get around that? Easy, find the middle, dig down, then dig the other blocks down as well. So right here, this dirt, this can actually come out, which means we need to get back to the floor work. We need to beautify this area too. It all needs to look good. Yes, I'm gonna be like that, I'm sorry. I know, I'm being OCD about how my farm looks. Definitely need it to look beautiful. This is going to be the best looking mob spawner that you have ever seen. All of YouTube, Mumbo Jumbo, Etho, Grian, yep, they have nothing on this, again, beautiful mob spawner. So anyways, we have our trench right here, one block wide, four blocks right there, dip down, five blocks right here, wall. Wall is a problem. We're gonna need to cut into the wall a couple of blocks. By a couple, I mean literally a couple, or three blocks? Yep, three blocks into the wall right there, and also three blocks high. Boom, just like that, that's gonna be perfect. Now temporarily, we're gonna put a dirt block right there, and we're gonna dig this block out. Eventually, we'll be putting a block of ice right here, but for now, we're gonna wanna dig it out, like I just did, and do that. Then, we're actually gonna drop a water bucket in there. More on that in a few, though. Now, the rest of this floor needs to be fixed. Whoops, sorry, I dropped water into my cave. I'm sorry, cave. The torches are gonna go away. You know what? I gotta fix it. Imagining that I have a mob elevator right here, it's gonna raise the mobs up, then it's gonna move them over in line this way. Maybe, I don't know, let's go one, two, three, maybe four blocks. It'll move them four blocks over, and then drop them. Or three blocks. Let's go three blocks. I like three a little bit better. Three's a better number. So this will move the mobs three blocks over and then drop them all the way down into this room in here where I just dumped the water. I want the mobs to land on, let's say, this block right here. This feels like a pretty good block. Now, that's the bottom of our mob spawner room. I guarantee that the spawner will be active from down in this room, but to double check, all we need to do, poke a small hole in the floor, and then we just basically move around. Is the spawner on? No, it's not. But if we move up one block right there, it is on. So that's golden. That's perfect. Which means that's gonna work. Now our mobs, again, are gonna fall onto this block right here. It honestly might not be active from all the way over there, though. So let's check this out. If we're all the way over here, is it gonna be active? We're gonna have to take out a little bit of the wall. Let's see. What do we have here? It is not active. And still not active, but active right here. Okay, that's good. And then if we move over, it's active still. Okay, so what we're gonna do is actually move this over one more block. We're gonna move the mobs over literally, I think this would be two blocks now, and then drop them right here. Then to make sure the spawner is active in even more areas, we're actually gonna raise the floor of this cave up a couple blocks. Now today, we're not really worried about the aesthetics of this farm at all, and that includes the grinding room. So for now, we're just gonna fill it in with cobblestone. Eventually, we can definitely come back in here and care about it a little bit more. So let's go maybe one block up and then, how are we feeling about this? Okay, scratch that. This is gonna be the floor level. It doesn't look very good right now, okay? Just pretend that it looks okay. I've raised the floor up quite a few more blocks, so we're even closer to the spawner, so I know for sure that it's going to be active in most of this room that eventually will look really good. So now we need to make a mob elevator and a dropper. What we're gonna wanna do is get the coordinates of the block that we're going to want to drop our mobs onto, which is going to be this block right here. We're gonna go ahead and write those coordinates down in the chat so we have them. Freeze. This moment right here is where I make a gigantic mistake. So take a look at the coordinates in chat. The first one, that's good, 54. The second one, 50. Nope, wrong. We're at 40. I mistyped it in the chat. Basically, as you'll see, I'm going to make an elevator that is a little bit too tall for this spot right here. Actually, 10 blocks too tall. We fix it later on, but just wanted to make that clear that that was a total accident on my part, and I didn't realize it right away. All of the numbers that I'll be talking about, the whole 22 blocks, definitely still apply, but make sure you have the correct Y coordinate, not the wrong one. kind of important. Anyways, I was saying, these are the coordinates right there. Now, take that middle coordinate, the Y coordinate, and add 22 to it. So if we add 22 to that, we're gonna get 72. Boom, easy, quick math. 72 is going to be our golden number. We need to make our mob elevator go all the way up to 72 and then drop down onto this block right here. If we move our zombies up to 72 and then drop them, they'll fall 22 blocks and land on this block. And then I'll be able to stand down here, swing at them, and take them out. It's gonna be amazing. One of the best things ever. Move back into this room that you've dug here. Again, big platform right here, little trench right here. Follow the trench down over to your elevator. Make sure your elevator is fully blocked in just like that. Now, we need to go all the way up to 72. How are we gonna do that? Well, easy. We're just gonna tower all the way up there. Now, while you're towering all the way up there, you're gonna wanna make your elevator 2 blocks wide, and make sure you put a water source right there in front of the back block of your elevator. While you dig your elevator all the way up to whatever height you have to dig it to, it might not be 72, but for me, it is 72, we're gonna wanna go ahead and patch any holes that might be in this elevator. So right there was a hole, I went ahead and patched it. In just a second, we're gonna actually put water inside of this elevator and then put a bunch of signs in the elevator as well. But first, of course, before anything, we need to get the elevator all the way up to its final height. And coincidentally, it's nighttime right now, so that puts a lot more risk in our game today. But it's gonna be easy because right here, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72. Boom, that's gonna be the spot. Then we're gonna move it over to, what was the coordinate again? 54, negative 74, which is gonna be this block right there. And then we're gonna dig straight down. All the way around this stuff up here, we're gonna wanna have blocks encasing it. Aye, creeper, creeper, creeper. Ah, okay, okay. Don't build at nighttime. Don't build at nighttime, gamers. Now, once you have the floor up to whatever layer you need, so again, in our case, 72, again, 22 blocks above wherever we want our zombies to land, make the ceiling 3 blocks high. All right, so just to double check everything, 54, negative 74, that's gonna be our block right there. What we're gonna wanna do up here inside of this room right now is put a sign. Now, usually your spawner wouldn't be so far up above the ground. Usually, you would probably still be under the ground. You wouldn't be in daylight. Basically, you're gonna want a sign above wherever you're going to be dropping your zombies or your skeletons. Now we'll go ahead and finish the structure off with a couple more blocks. Then we're gonna actually go inside of it. It's gonna get dark, but it's okay because we're just gonna dig straight down. Now be careful. Of course, digging straight down is very, very dangerous. Usually I don't recommend it. It could potentially be a small brain move, but it could also potentially be a very, very big brain move that saves you a lot of time. I'm living on the edge here. Boom, it saved me a lot of time. That's exactly what I wanted. Now we're gonna go ahead and finish encasing this over here, and then we'll actually be back to this to talk about how we finish it off in a few minutes. Now it's elevator time, for real. Now there are a couple ways to tackle this one. This is how I'm going to tackle it. I'm gonna actually climb right back inside of this thing over here and then jump down in. Then I'm gonna dump a water bucket in here at the back of my elevator, which is gonna be this block right here. So water bucket right there. Now I'm gonna carefully not fall down there, put a sign right there that should change the water to flow that way, which is great, but we don't wanna fall there. That would be really, really dangerous. Now we can actually go ahead and cover that back in. We don't need that there. And then we're just gonna dig straight down and remove blocks and let the water fall down. As we do that, we're gonna place signs in here on the other block, the inside block, you see above the water right there, kind of hard to see, but the water's right there. Yeah, we're gonna put signs right there so the water is only on this back block. By back block, I mean like the block farthest away from your room, if that makes any sense. Also, don't drown in your elevator. That would be embarrassing. Now again, this is only one of the ways to do this. Another way to do this is starting from the bottom. If you go to the bottom of this thing and dig the blocks out as you go, you could place water sources, float up, go back down, grab more water with your water buckets, and kind of repeat the process over and over and over again. Definitely would work, but it's also not the game that I'm trying to play today. I'm trying to get this thing done as quick as possible. And if you want to get this thing done as quick as possible, start from the top with a single water source and work your way down to the bottom. All right, so it looks like I'm gonna be just a couple signs short. No big deal. I'm gonna let the water spill over right there so I can easily swim right back up this thing. Now, right now, the water is falling right down into that one block. That's kind of convenient. Earlier on, we put the water in that one block just in case we wanted to jump back down the elevator and get into our room quickly. If you don't put the water source there, that's actually honestly fine, but it does make it a little bit more dangerous, because if you were to actually fall out of your elevator, especially from a high height, you would have to, we'll say, hit that respawn button, if you know what I mean. So the final two signs, boom right there, boom right there. Now we can go ahead and remove these two blocks. Now the water flows all the way down here. That's perfect. Now at this point, if you don't have water right there, you definitely want to put water right there. Grab some kelp and now swim all the way up and plant kelp. The reason we're doing this is to turn all of these blocks into water sources. Currently, at least before the kelp, we had one water source. That water source was this top one right there. Now that we planted all of this kelp in here, we have all the water sources. The reason we need all of those blocks to be water sources, simple. One simple block, this block right here. The reasoning, bubble column. We place the soul sand right there, give it a second, and then a bubble column will activate right there. Then we can go ahead and test it if we want by jumping into it, but we don't really want to test it. I know it works. So we can jump back into the water and then finally remove the water. Place an ice block right there. That ice block is very important. That needs to stay there forever. Don't let the ice go away. If you're using normal ice, don't let it go out. Next up, it's time to finish everything up in this room. Water source right there, then we're gonna jump back up this ladder and grab some more water. We need water all along the back side? The side, I don't know. Depending on how you're looking at it, the back side of the room. Depending on how you're not looking at it, not the back side of the room. Basically, the side opposite the trench. Line it with water sources, and then we're gonna need to knock out all of the torches and get out of this room quickly. So, to reach the torches, we're probably gonna need to tower up. Let's go maybe, well, you know what? We might not need to. Okay, this is the moment of speed right there. Boom, one right there. The zombies are spawning already, but don't worry about it. Zombies can't hit you from up close. Go away, zombie. You are disgusting. You can go ahead and keep going away. Thank you very much. Go right on up that water stream. Another one right there, but another zombie. But hey, look at that. We can send him flying away. Now all we have to do is climb up this ladder and then actually climb right back down the ladder to get rid of the ladders. We definitely don't want to leave the ladders in there. Finally, if we just replace the wall back with like cobblestone or something, I know, amazing looking. That's what I've been saying this whole episode. Boom, we're gonna be good. We can seal that room off fully. Now, because we have zombies, we want to get down low really, really quick and grab some slabs. Baby zombies are indeed a thing. We want to stop them from getting out. To stop them from getting out, slab right there, and then solid blocks around the other sides, or even more slabs. Now, for now, you have to excuse the appearance of this room, please. I know, it's not the best looking thing, but it's fine. We'll make it look a little bit better later on. The big point here is that this spawner is now functioning, but we might have a small problem. I might have a small miscalculation in here. I'm not 100% sure, but we're gonna need to see. Do the zombies continually just fall and die here? Because if they do, we're gonna need to actually move. Yep, they do. What if we move it up one block? Will one block fix that problem? That's interesting. Okay, no. They're taking damage somewhere. Where would they be taking damage? Well, the good thing is the fact that our zombies are continually falling into this thing. That means the spawner is actually spawning. Oh, there's a creeper. There's a creeper. Where did that creeper even come from? You gotta go away, man. You have to go away. You can't exist here. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. That's the problem. That's the problem. Right here is the problem. I don't know where I got that 50 number from before. It's gone. But the Y coordinate is actually... it's actually pretty low. I way overshot it. Our floor should be like all the way up there. Okay, well, there's two ways to fix this. Way number one, easy, move the floor up, which I'm honestly thinking we could do. We could literally just move the floor of this room upwards. How did I mess that up? That's crazy. I guess that gives us the perfect opportunity to get a better floor in here, but wow, that's crazy. Okay, we need to readjust the floor. So we can work backwards here. We have our elevator that goes all the way up to 72. What we're gonna need to do is minus 22 from that and then make them land on Y50. That's actually not that hard to do. All we need to do, move into this room and tower all the way up to Y50, place a block down, and then boom, we should be golden. So let's see, Y50 is gonna be quite a ways up. How did I do that? I must have written down the wrong coordinate, like entirely. Completely wrong coordinate. Y50, boom, look at that, that's golden. That's exactly what we needed. There's a zombie standing on that block, perfect. Which means that our new floor actually needs to be all the way up there. Yeah, that's my bad. My bad entirely. With our floor placed on the correct level, we now have something that looks like this. Check this out. We move over to here, swing at the zombies, and they're all mowed down. Nice and easily, and we get tons and tons of levels. That was exactly the plan. The whole zombies going away really easily thing. Not the whole mistake part. Well, the other nice thing about moving the room up is we now technically do have the option to put a window into this room. We could do it, but the room looks terrible. Am I going to do that? Well, that's going to be a job for another time. I'm going to put some thought into it and think about it. The final thing that I need to do is just find my way out of here. I'm thinking that if we dig back maybe a couple blocks, maybe something like that, then we should be able to dig a straight hallway through here. Okay, you know what? Maybe one more block back, but then we straight hallway and we should land over where our resources are waiting for us. Is that going to happen? Is it going to work out like that? I think it will. Oh, yes, it definitely will. Okay, perfect. Which means this old staircase can all be filled in. I can go ahead and clean things up and make sure torches are good everywhere. We definitely don't want any more random spawns down here. And then we can meet back up over at the other base. Aha, I also found where all of these mobs are coming from. So first things first, there's a ravine right there that I just shot a creeper clear across. Second thing second, there was a mine. Oh, more diamonds. Oh, yes, they're coming home with me for sure. Oh, yeah, definitely. There was an unlit mine shaft right over here, really, really close to our room. That's where these creatures were coming from. Oh, yeah, you know what time it is? It's carrot time. Oh, yeah. All right, so it's that time of the day again. It's time for the comment of the day. Today's comment of the day is a simple question. Waddles, what's your go-to food? Now, my go-to food, definitely, hands down, a steak. Now, believe it or not, actually, like, for the longest time, my go-to food actually was carrots, and then it was melons, and maybe baked potatoes for a while. Definitely carrots and melons, though, but I think, to be fair, maybe carrots and maybe even melons were both a little bit better before. Not 100% sure, though. But honestly, steak is my go-to food because of how easy it is to set up a cow farm. I mean, this cow crusher over here, it is so simple. I mean, there's, like, nothing to it. You only need, like, 5 iron. That's the most expensive thing to it, which is, like, amazing. I love how simple the cow farm is. But check this out. I don't know what's going on here. I noticed this in between episodes. It's kind of tricky to feed. I don't know if it's just, well, I guess then again, maybe it's not even doing it. Okay, never mind. Now, we need to wind today's episode out with one final thing. Enchanting. We need a better bow, just hands down. I want a bow with, like, power on it. So maybe, or maybe even unbreaking. Unbreaking is okay, that's a start. Let's see what this bow would be. If it's good, we'll keep it. If it's bad, we'll disenchant. Unbreaking 3, okay, yep. That is honestly pretty bad. We could probably just get a better bow. So let's go ahead and turn that back into levels. And then what would we get next time? Flame. All right. well, I guess everything can't be great. Until next time, it's been me, your boy Waddles. Today, big shout out to my patrons, ColeYo95, NerdPantsMcGee, and JRig42.